So of course I'm crying already.
Thank you for your goodness and mercy and love. And Lord, this is truly the day that you have made, and we rejoice and we're glad in it. God, we thank you for this celebration today of 20 years of marriage, God. 20 years of holy matrimony. 20 years of loving and serving one another, Lord God. It is great. It is grand and glorious in our eyes. And we pray, even as we have this recommitment ceremony, that you would be in control and in charge, God. Every word that's spoken, every song that's sung, God, every remark that's given through the course of this day, let it be to your honor and to your glory. So, Lord, we're thanking you right now in advance for the miracle you're going to work as we gather with this family. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. Well, I guess most of you already know, first of all, that this was a surprise. So, praise the Lord, surprise. And, I tell you, it's just a great thing to be able to have a family that loves you that much. I tell you, this family came together and they did a whole lot to make this celebration happen. And so I commend the family for what they did and how you conducted yourself, and those who joined with them and those who served with them, family and friends, and we all are family. We thank God for the Lord who makes us all one in Him, and so we're grateful to the Lord. I always make a few remarks before I begin a ceremony, and those remarks are pretty much the same. You know, I really believe that even though the world thinks that marriage doesn't work, you guys are living proof that it really does. Okay? You guys been able to stand the test of time, and the end is not yet, but you've had some great, great years, 20 years together. And so, you know, when I think about marriage, you know, I think about the fact that it wasn't man's idea, but it was God's perfect plan. And the only time marriage doesn't work is when God, when man tries to do it on his own way, his own eyes. And so God created marriage to typify his relationship with Christ and the church. And of course, the unity that is expressed in the Godhead, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And so what you entered into 20 years ago was a covenant agreement. It's more powerful than a legal contract. A legal contract today, you're breaking those. You know, but a covenant with God, we stand, we trust God, because God always keeps his part. And you guys have kept your part, and we're thankful and grateful, and you have to show forth some wonderful families, some wonderful children that I'm sure that you're proud of, and we're grateful to God for what you have done as you have served together. I knew it wasn't, I know it's not a singular thing that you guys work together to make that a reality, so I celebrate with you also your children who are goodly and godly, have a goodly, godly heritage, and we are grateful to God for that. Finally, I'm going to share the two scriptures I used to share is that, you know, there's a Bible, the Bible tells a story about a man who, you know, two men to build a house, and one built it on, you know, on rock, and one built it on sand. The Bible says that the storms and the floods, okay, the waves came against both houses. So that means that every marriage, every life is going to be storms. It wasn't like just a house that was on sand got the storm, and the house on the solid rock. Listen, they all got storms. But it was after the storm was over is where the real test was. And the house in the sand fell flat, but the house that was built on a rock stood firm. And that rock is Jesus Christ. And you built your marriage thus far with the help of the Lord, and that rock has kept you. And that's the reason why through the storms, and I know you've had storms, you had rain and you had floods, but guess what? The Lord has kept you, and I'm just delighted, and we're all excited about that, and that's why we celebrate here today. And then lastly, the Bible says, let the Lord build a house. They labor in vain that build it. And so God doesn't want to just be, you know, the foundation of the relationship. He wants to continue to be every brick. And you're still building. Okay, you're still building. So every brick, all the more to come together, it's him. It's Jesus Christ. And he's the one that really makes a difference. Amen? Amen. All right. Well, we're going to begin. Dearly beloved, we have come together in the presence of these witnesses to rejoin and renew the commitment of this man and woman in holy matrimony. The sacred relationship of marriage was established by God in creation, and our Lord Jesus Christ adorned marriage by his presence at the first miracle at the wedding of Cana of Galilee. The Apostle Paul chose marriage to symbolize the union between Christ and his church, and the Holy Scriptures commend marriage to be honorable among all people. The union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for their mutual joy and for help and for comfort given to one another in prosperity and adversity. And when is the will of God, and it was his will, okay, for you to have children, as well as nurture the knowledge and the love of the Lord. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly or soberly, but deliberately and in reverent fear before the Lord. And you entered into marriage 20 years ago with that same heartfelt commitment. And so we see you here today. And so into this holy union, we are grateful that we are gathered together to renew your vows, because you've made those vows sometime again. So we're going to renew those vows between Andrew and Gail at this time. So what I'm going to do is just say, you listen, and then you'll just say, I will, or I do, whatever you like. Okay. All right. Andrew Nichols, will you continue to have this woman as your wife, to live together in the holy covenant of marriage? Will you continue to love and comfort her and honor her and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, being faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Gail Brown Nichols, will you have this man and continue to have him, to live together in the holy covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort and honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, being faithful to him as long as you both shall live? And I know you walked up the aisle with the, who gives and continues to give this company together? Let's say we all do. And so say we all. All right. The Lord Jesus taught us at the beginning of creation that he made them male and female. For this cause shall a man leave his mother and his father, and shall cleave to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. Consequently, you guys no longer are two, and have no longer been two for 20 years. Okay, but one flesh. You have come today to renew your vows as husband and wife, and so you're already joining hands. So what I want you to do is repeat after me, but looking at each other in each other's eyes at this time. Come into that.
Drop the ball.
All right, you can't after me. I, Andrew.
I, Andrew.
Take you, Gail. To continue to be my wife.
To have and to hold.
From this day.
Forward.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To
love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
As God is my witness.
I continue my promise.
I, Gail.
Take you, Andrew.
To continue to be my husband.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward. For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish. Until we are parted by death.
As God is my witness.
I give you my promise.
All right. Now look at me again. The word of the Lord describes the kind of love we have to have for each other. It says love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not jealous. Love does not brag and is not arrogant. It does not act unbecomingly. It does not seek its own. It's not easily provoked. It does not take into account wrong suffered. It does not rejoice in unrighteousness, but rejoices with truth. Bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. At this point in time, we're going to have the exchanging of rings. Surprise! Okay. All right. And you know what? You can take them out of the boxes now. Yeah. Gotta work. Okay, give me. All right. Now, the rings are the outward and visible sign of an inner commitment. And Andrew and Gail, you have kept that commitment, and you've been an example to others about what commitment means. And we always share with people that commitment means keeping a promise you made even when you don't feel like it. Okay? You know that in marriage you have days where you always will love, but sometimes you don't like each other that much. Sometimes you have those days, right? All right. Well, listen, that happens. These emblems and signs are reminders of that commitment. And so they're signs of that, and there's a lot to be said about the metal that it's made of. It's very precious, all right? And your love is precious. It's very costly, and your love cost you many times, but it's worth it. It's worth it. And also, too, the shape of the ring is in the shape of a circle, which typifies an unending eternal relationship. I know you've kept it for 20 years, and the same God that kept you for these 20 years will continue to keep you for 20 plus years. By the grace of God. All right, and so we're going to pray for these emblems. Let's pray. Dear God and Father, I thank you, God, for these emblems and signs. God, we thank you, God, that you have created them to be reminders to the wearers. Oh God, that they are in a relationship that is committed. God, that your love and affection is only for one, God, the husband and the wife. So I pray as they wear these rings going forward, Lord God, that you, oh God, will bless them, Lord. Protect them. Watch over them, Lord God. Let it even be an indication to others who might have other designs that they are committed to a relationship. Oh God, I pray, oh God, that you would bless these rings. God, as they continue to wear it, I pray for long life. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Now, I was made aware that this is a first really kind of ceremony you guys have had.
Yes.
And that is a wonderful thing that I think that the family is interested in, the fact that I know when you initially were married, it was just in a chapel, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And that's not a bad thing. It was still real. It was still, you know, an occasion that God honored and God showed up at. Well, he's here today for the commitment. Mm-hmm. And these rings, I believe, will be the first time you praise the Lord. All right, so what we're going to do, what we're going to do is we're going to do the exchange of the rings. So first of all, I'm going to ask you, Andrew, to place this on Gail's hand ring finger. And repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I have.
With all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
Of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit.
Amen. Now you place this on the left hand ring finger. Repeat after me. Whichever one you have. Yes. Yeah, that's all right. All right. I give you this ring. As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have. I honor you. In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Mm-hmm. All right. Right. Great.
Yes.
Now I understand that we're going to have a candle right here. Is that going to happen? All right. Now we're just over here. So we're just going to move over to this venue. We're going to move up. And we're going to have someone to please light the outside candle. Okay, now what we're going to do, we're going to enter into this part of the ceremony. Now, these candles are pretty much, they represent the separate candles being lit. That was your lives 20 years ago, all right? They've been joined together for a while, but what we're doing as we renew these vows, we want to be able to take these separate candles. And of course, these separate candles, as you join them in the center, it will just typify what you've enjoyed and experienced for the last 20 years. But it's just a symbol and sign, and it's an outward sign to those that are here. There's some here that are married, there's some here that will be married, and this is a great sign to show them how this really takes place. So I'm going to ask each one of you to take the outer candle. Isn't that beautiful? All right. And now I want you to light the center candle, please. All right, and then extinguish your candles without going through the veil, though. Don't go through the veil. Just that veil. That's it. Beautiful. Now, I just want to say this, ladies and gentlemen, that this is something that was done 20 years ago. When people marry, they're no longer single. They're one. The Bible says the two shall become one. And just as you know, this candle burns in the center, it shows you two lives being merged together. And so, from this point and for the last 20 years, you know, you don't make decisions on your own. You know, you come together and you decide together and you work together and you love together, and it's a beautiful example to your children. And I pray that as this center light stays lit, you know, this light will after a while go out. But your light will be continually lit all the days of your life. You can continue to enjoy that oneness that God established with you 20 years ago. All right, you can come back to the center. Right. Now that Andrew and Gail have once again renewed their vows and recommitted to one another, giving themselves to each other with solemn vows before us and God and man and the witnesses, and showing their affection by the giving and the receiving of rings. And you know what I'm going to do? But I'm just, you know what? I want to, let me pray first, and then we'll do this pronouncement. Dear God and Father, I want to thank you, God, for what you've already done. God, you've done some great, great things in the life of Andrew and Gail. Lord, we're just so excited, God. We're so delighted for what you have done. Thank you for what they have meant, Lord God, to their family, their children, Lord God. Thank you for the examples they have set before them. Thank you for how they have loved them and nurtured them in the fear and admonition of the Lord. Thank you, Lord, for how they have been in the Bethel family, been a family that stands out head and shoulders among many of them, many of the families there, because of their love and their dedication and their service, oh God, to you. And now their children serve with the same love and zeal. We thank you, God. We're grateful, Lord. We don't take it lightly. You have done great things. So we're giving thanks for what you have already done. Thank you for the 20 years, oh God, that they have been together, Lord God. And we pray, oh God, right now you continue to keep your hand upon them. Lord, I pray, oh God, for health and strength, God. I come against every sickness, every disease in the name of Jesus. Nothing will come nigh their dwelling, Lord. I pray, oh God, that you strengthen them, oh God, in their physical bodies, Lord God, mentally, oh God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, emotionally, God. I pray that you keep them solid, God, and balanced. Oh God, in your precious name. God, I pray you bless them, Lord God, and all they put their hands to do, Lord. I pray you bless them in their finances. I pray, oh God, for increase, God. I pray for expansion in the name of Jesus, Lord God. I pray they will never want for anything as they continue to be faithful, Lord, as they give, Lord, that you bless them, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, Lord God. I pray for a time in their life, God, they will have more than enough, God, so much that they will be able to share, oh God, to countless hundreds and thousands. In the name of Jesus, God, I pray, oh God, that you just bless them, Lord God, in their commitment to each other. I pray for increase even in their love for each other and their affection. God, I pray that this day will be a day that they will not forget, Lord God, that they will remember, oh God, families coming together, Lord, their children honoring them, celebrating them. Oh God, I pray it will be a great, great day in their memory, God. And now I pray, Lord God, for an anointing, a continued anointing on their lives, Lord Jesus. God, a supernatural anointing that when any of them open their mouth, that you will speak, whether it's in the home to their children, whether there is it's in a congregation, God, wherever they may be, Lord, that they will be lights and example, salt and light, God, before they even open their mouth, that people will see the way they live and the love that they have for each other. And when they ask the reason of the hope that's within them, they will let them know that Jesus Christ in the life has made the difference. So we're excited today, Lord. I thank you for the families that come together to celebrate, Lord. I pray they will continue to honor them. Your children will continue to honor them, not just with this celebration, but every day of their life. Because you said if we honor our parents, God, our days will be long. And surely they have given a shining example today, oh God, of honoring those and giving honor to where honor is due. So we thank you today, and I pray that the remainder of this day will be a great day of continued celebration in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Now, all right, now that Andrew and Gail have given themselves to each other in solemn vows and renewed their commitment before us and God as witnesses and have shown their affection and trust by the giving and the receiving of rings and by the joining of hands. This is not a pronouncement, but I just celebrate 20 years of glorious, wonderful marriage together, and I declare again that they are husband and wife in the name of God the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And therefore, what God has joined together, let no man separate. You may once again celebrate and salute your bride. All right, everyone can stand and receive the kindness of our God.